morning, dear students. Today's our lecture is concerned about Mendel's laws of inheritance. According to Mendel, or Mendel proposed that the three basic laws occurs during inheritance pattern. That means during genetic character transfer from parent to their offspring, that pattern is called as inheritance pattern, according to Mendel. There are three basic laws, such as number one is law of dominance, second one is law of segregation or law of purity of gametes, and third one is law of independent assortment. In this law of dominance, first law of Mendel proposed that the law of dominance in monohybrid and dihybrid crosses, the phenotypic characters are controlled by units. That units are called as factors. That means during dihybrid cross or monohybrid cross, phenotypic characters are controlled. Phenotypic characters means what? Phenotypic characters means external appearance of an organism. External characters of that particular organism or that particular plant. That means phenotypic characters. And external characters or phenotypic characters of that particular plants or that particular organism in case of monohybrid cross or in case of dihybrid cross, always controlled by unit. That small unit is called as factor. In dissimilar pairs of factors, dissimilar pairs, pairs means jodi, dissimilar pair of factor, that pair include two factors. One members of the pair is dominant, that means dominant, and that dominant character over the others, that other becomes recessive. That means dominant character overlap, dominant character always overlap on recessive character, and dominant character is denoted by capital letter and a recessive character is denoted by small letter. The law of dominance is used to explain the expression of only one of the parental characters of monohybrid cross F1. That means in this law explain the expression of only one character out of two factors present in a pair, and out of that two factors only one character expresses in F1 hybrid or F1 generation, and second one is not expressed or not appearing in F1. That's why dominant, one is dominant, another one is recessive. One is dominant denoted by capital letter, another one is recessive character denoted by small letter. This dominant character always appears in F1 and recessive character do not appear in F1 generation. But both are expressed in F2 generation. But in this law, in the law proposed, the dominant character always appear in F1, whereas the recessive character do not appear in F1. This is a main theme of law of dominance. With their statement and explanation of law of dominance with suitable example. For example, monohybrid cross. With their parental phenotypes are tall pea plant cross with dwarf pea plant. Their genotypes are capital T, tall cross with small t, dwarf. Both are homozygous parents. One tall pea plant with homozygous, that means both the allelic pair are always homozygous. These two factors always homozygous. Cross with here small t always homozygous. But here homozygous for dwarfness and homozygous for tallness. After that, gametes of this cross are only one common capital T cross with here also small t. And after gamete formation, both the gametes mix to each other, that is crossing over between these two gametes. Capital T mix with small t, but in F1 progeny, in F1 generation, capital T small t appear, that means hybrid tall. In this hybrid tall, tallness always, that means capital T appear at first, and small t appear at second level. That means capital T dominant character always overlap on recessive characters. And here in F1 progeny, F1 generation, tall means dominant character always appear. And recessive character suppresses and dominant character expresses in this cross. First dominant parent is tall, that means capital T. Second parent, that is recessive parent, small t, crossing over between these two, dominant parent cross with recessive parent, dominant parent cross with recessive parent, and their F1 generation, F1 offsprings obtained, that is dominant capital T small t. Here hybrid, two dissimilar factors present in this pair. In this pair, capital T small t, that becomes heterozygous. Both the parents are homozygous. One is homozygous for tall, another is homozygous for dwarf. But their progeny appear as heterozygous, dominant capital T small t here dominancy always occur in these progeny is always dominant capital T. Appear in F1 and recessive small t does not appear in F1 generation, hence law of dominance. Now, on the basis of this example, this law states that, means their statement is, when two homozygous individuals with one or more sets of contrasting characters are crossed. इथे आपण एकच कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कॅरेक्टर घेतलेला आहे. एक्झाम्पल मोनोहायब्रिड क्रॉस दिलेला आहे, ते म्हणजे टॉल डॉर्फ. वेन टू होमोझायगस इंडिव्हिज्युअल्स विथ वन सेट ऑफ कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कॅरेक्टर्स, वी हॅव टू सिलेक्टेड एज वन ओनली वन कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कॅरेक्टर अमंग सेवन कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कॅरेक्टर्स are crossed, the alleles that appears in F1 are dominant. ये dominant था, ये recessive था, लेकिन F1 generation में dominant आ गया. Dominant. And those which do not appear, these do not appear at first, do not appear In F1, they are always recessive. That means dominant character always appear in F1 and recessive character does not appear in F1. This is law of dominant according to Mendel. That's all. Thank you.